Now let's go back to our line current example. We have just found all of the vectors that we need, and the next thing that we need to do is start to apply the equation. The equation here is dH equals I, and that I is going to include this I value times dL that I've got here, crossed with R divided by 4 pi R squared. So let's do that. I, in our case, is 3 amps in the x direction. And because I need to include the dL term, let me write that right in here. Let's go back and figure out what our dL is going to be. If I want to break this up into little pieces and later add it up, I can see that my dL term right here is equal to dx. If my current had been in the y direction instead, my dL term would have been dy. So let's go use that here. So instead of dL, this is dx. Now, the easiest way for me to do I cross R is to use this matrix. And I'm going to put x, y, and z vectors across the top. And to remind myself to make this one negative, I'm putting a little negative sign right there. Then I'm going to put I in the first row, and that's where I have 3 amps times dx, and I have nothing in the y and nothing in the z. Then right here, I'm going to put the r vector. Let's go back and take a look at the r vector. The r vector is right here. So you can see that we have an xs term and a yp minus 2 term. So let's go plug that in. It's minus xs, and it's yp minus 2, and it's 0 in the z direction. So let's do our cross product. Our cross product is going to have an x term. The way I find the x term is I cross out my column and my row that have x in it, and then I'm just going to circle. These two are multiplied, and I subtract off these two multiplied. It's 0 in the x direction. Now let's do the y component. I just put a minus y here, and I'm going to do the same thing. Cross out the column and the row that y is in, so it's going to be 3dx times 0 minus xs times 0. Put a negative sign on that. That whole thing is 0. Now let's do the z component. The z component is going to be 3dx times yp minus 2 times yp minus 2 minus those two multiplied, minus 0. So you can see that I'm going to get I cross R is going to have only a z component, and this is what it's going to be. Now let's apply Biot-Savart law. Here I want to find my magnetic field, and it's going to be I cross R divided by 4 pi R squared. So it's going to be z hat 3 times yp minus 2 times dx divided by 4 pi, oops, and this should have been 3, sorry, 4 pi, and this magnitude is going to be xs squared plus yp minus 2 squared, square rooted, and then I'm going to cube it. There's my dH term. Let's see what I'm going to integrate. Let's take a careful look at this dx. Let's go back and see what we're integrating. Right here is my line current, and I've broken it up into little pieces, dx. Since I'm integrating over the source, not the field point, this is a dxs integration. So when I come back here, I can see that I'm going to be integrating on xs. This is the variable of integration. Yp acts as if it is constant in this integration, but xs is the variable we're going to be integrating. It's very common that you end up with an integral that is complicated enough you may not want to solve it by hand. That's okay. You'll learn how to do numerical integration in our Biot-Savart lab. Now let's figure out what our integration is going to be. H is going to be this integral, this thing right here, integrated over xs, and xs goes from 1 to 3. So there was going to be the thing that we're going to be integrating.